Good morning, YouTubers. Thanks for coming back to the channel. Where to today? Well, today we're riding with the Ulysses motorbike group, and they're doing their what they call the Ulysses Odyssey run. Once a year, one of the branches in various states takes the leadership and has an annual run, or organises the annual run. This year it's a Joondalup Ulysses branch, and they've decided to go to Esperance, a lovely town south of Perth. It's around about 750 kilometres away from Perth. It's a good run. Not the prettiest of countries on the way down. Several ways to go, Brooklyn Highway or Albany Highway through to Williams and Wagen and turn off. Newdegate, Lake Grace, Lake King, Ravensthorpe, and then Esperance. It's our long weekend over here in September. So we're most of us are riding down or going down on the Friday, come back Monday. There's a few that are actually leaving on the Thursday to break the trip up a little bit and enjoy the countryside. Anyway, enjoy the ride. Come with us for the Ulysses Odyssey Esperance motorbike run. All the best. Thanks. Bye. Beautiful day and on the road to Esperance, 750 kilometres southwest of Perth on the coast. We'll pass through a couple of towns on the way through and I'll have a chat if I've got time. The first one we're going to stop at is Newdegate. They've got some painted silos in Newdegate. Newdegate itself is a little country town. It's actually 400 kilometres southeast of Perth and 50 k's away from Lake Grace. After Lake Grace, we move on to Lake King, which I think is around about here. It's the salt lakes of Lake King. Lake King's really a tavern and a petrol station, servicing the farming community at this neck of the woods. We turn down from Lake King down to Ravensthorpe. There's some painted silos there as well. We'll have a look at those while we're there. Put the drone up. That's Ravensthorpe itself. Nice sized town. Painted silos there. The Ravensthorpe silos were painted by an artist by the name of Monk Island, and the ones we saw at Newdegate were painted by a different artist by the name of Brenton C. Back on the road, heading down, you pass through Ravensthorpe, and between Ravensthorpe and they call Munglinup is a nickel mine. What are we looking at? A conveyor belt. This conveyor belt runs from the nickel mine itself, which you can see on the horizon, all the way back, and obviously crosses over that main highway, which is the road from Ravensthorpe down to Esperance. And that's the other way for the tailings or the conveyor belt.
Great job.
Friday night Esperance, Ulysses Odyssey, barbecue. Catch up and say hello. Great night. And the Saturday we had a bit of a ride around the loop, which covers the coastline through via Pink Lake and back along the coast road through Twilight Bay. And this is Twilight Cove. The actual Esperance Surf Lifesaving Club is based here. But just some spectacular beaches around Esperance. The sand is actually almost silicon, squeaks when you walk on it. That evening we had a dinner at the local football club and entertained a bit later on by Barry.
I joined the Ulysses in 2008, and I think our first Odyssey was Geraldton. And I didn't know this way. The next Odyssey was 2009, Kalgoorlie. I still didn't know this person. Then we had the 2010 AGM Albany. I had a little dog Chloe. We pulled up at the pace. ready to go into the AGM at the pretty oval there, and they've got this sign, no dogs. No dogs at an AGM. Oh, well, I went around the other way and cut across through the car park. And I'm walking down through the exhibitions and the motorbikes. And anyway, this bloke comes up on a quad, riding a quad. You can't have a dog in here. You know, you've got to leave. Oh, look at this bloke. He's got a...
You want to know a juggler's? Sorry, balls in the air, yeah? What's the difference between a juggler and a pizza? A pizza can feed a family of four. Boom, boom, Tommy Cooper. Not bad, huh? So we're going to do a little skit. It's about a trip that we did to the Lismore Rally. I've been with the Ulysses a couple of years. I thought I'd done a few long rides, but I hadn't met Ken Eaton at that stage. Now I know what a long ride is.
This is the Ulysses, and you'll run to the Lismore Rally. Over red dust plains with winter rain. Remember Tenworth, many days and many caves over wide open country. The feeling only if I could know. He's our leader, he's the man, that's the end of the view, with a dog tied on, he knows all the roads, all the kids and girls.
I'll just say, Daryl was with us, but Bruce is his substitute. Daryl's 6'4" and Bruce is 5'4". He's very good, right.
Ken's our leader, we're riding the line. We're one exception, we know our place. Jim doesn't lie. On the lawn, but as you
Sunday we went to a full-size replica of the original Stonehenge in the UK, which was built apparently around about 2000 years BC. The Stonehenge consists of 137 stones, and it's actually Esperance pink granite, and some of these individual stones weigh between 38 and 50 tons. Quite impressive. Truth. What got me was actually when you look at Stonehenge itself, although it's, there's no roof and quite open between the stones, the your voice carries and the reverberation within the complex or the stones is really quite impressive.
Maybe stop.
And a little bit of a drone shot. There's a crew. Some have come all the way from the East Coast. Stonehenge with the Bay of Isles in the background. From here, a few of the riders ride off through to the Cape Legrand National Park, Lucky Bay, Hellfire Bay, some spectacular coastline out that way. And after that, we met up at the Condinan Tavern for lunch. And then we followed on with a few photo shots of the Esperance town site, the jetty. So I hope you enjoy. All the best.
This is the Ulysses, and you run to the Lismore. Over Richter's plains with winter rain. Remember the tender many days and many caves of a wide open country. The feeling. Only if I could know. He's our leader. He's the man. Got the pink end of the view. With the dog tied on. He knows all the roads. All the kids and girls. Teddy is a star.